Hey there, I'm Benjamin from Loves Data. In this video, we're going to explore the enhanced measurement feature in Google Analytics 4, or GA4. Enhanced measurement lets you automatically track a number of important actions taking place on your website without having to modify your tracking code or adjusting your implementation in Google Tag Manager. Let's head to Google Analytics to take a look at enhanced measurement. Enhanced measurement can be configured for each of your data streams in Google Analytics 4. I'm currently in the admin area of Google Analytics, so let's start by selecting data streams. We can see my demo property has a single data stream, but you can create multiple data streams if you want to track additional websites into the same set of reports, or if you want to track your app and website. If you ever need to create an additional data stream, you can click Add Stream and select what you want to track. You'll then need to follow the steps to get up and running. Today we're going to look at my existing stream, but I've included a link in the extra resources in the description below this video if you'd like to learn more about getting started. Okay, let's select the existing data stream in our Google Analytics 4 property. We can see enhanced measurement at the top of the configuration for the stream. Let's click the configuration icon to view the actions that are being automatically tracked by enhanced measurement. First, we can see page views are automatically enabled. This means all of the pages people view on our website will be tracked into Google Analytics. This option can't be disabled. Next is scroll tracking. Enhanced measurement will automatically track people who view at least 90% of a page. Next is outbound clicks. Clicks to external domains will automatically be tracked as outbound clicks. Then there is site search. If you have a search function that people can use to search within your website, then enhanced measurement will automatically capture the search terms people are using. This option looks for common query parameters that are used for search functions. We'll talk more about site search in a moment, but for now, I just want to highlight that you can control this option by selecting Show Advanced Settings. We can now see the query parameters that enhanced measurement looks for in order to identify what people are searching for on your website. Next is video engagement. This will automatically track people watching YouTube videos you've embedded on your website, including when people click to play the video and when people watch 10%, 25%, 50%, 75%, and when they finish watching the video. Finally, enhanced measurement automatically tracks file downloads. This includes a range of common file types like PDFs, documents, text files, video, and audio files. If there are any actions you don't want automatically tracked into your reports, then you can click the switch on the right to disable them. This will stop events for those actions from being sent to Google Analytics. Okay, now that we've covered the different actions that can be automatically tracked, let's look at the information that is sent to Google Analytics in some more detail. Let's head to Google Tag Manager. I already have Google Analytics 4 added to my demo site using Google Tag Manager, so let's select Preview. And we want to ensure that the debug signal is included when we preview our website. Okay, now let's click Start. My demo site has now loaded, along with Tag Assistant, so we have a couple of options for understanding what information enhanced measurement is sending to Google Analytics. The first option is to select the Tag Assistant tab. We can then select the measurement ID for our Google Analytics 4 property at the top. This shows us all of the events that were sent to Google Analytics 4, and we can see there is a page view. Let's select this. We can now see all of the parameters that were sent to Google Analytics for this event. In particular, I want to highlight that the page view event includes the page location. This is the URL for the page on our website that we viewed. And we can also see the page title is sent as a parameter. So this means we can report on the titles for the pages people are viewing along with the page URLs. So we can see the information that is sent to Google Analytics using Tag Assistant. The other option is to use the debug view in Google Analytics. So let's head to Google Analytics. and let's select Debug View. This lets us view our reports as a timeline, and we can see our page view event is also available in this report. When we select the page view, we can then see the parameters including the page location and the page title. Okay, now let's head back to my demo site. Let's test the automatic scroll tracking. So let's scroll to the bottom of the page. And now let's select the Tag Assistant tab. If you would prefer to keep using the debug view, then you can use this option too, but I'm going to stick with Tag Assistant for the other events that are automatically collected by enhanced measurement. Let's select the scroll event. This event is automatically fired when people scroll 90% of a page on your website, and it includes details for the particular page someone scrolled. Let's close this and head back to my demo site. Now let's click an outbound link. And let's head back to Tag Assistant. We can see an event called Click has been collected. Let's select this event. For each outbound click, we can see that enhanced measurement will automatically collect the URL of the link, the top-level domain of the link, and any ID or class used for the link. Let's close this and head back to the demo site. Let's search within the demo site. Let's search for Contact. And now let's head to Tag Assistant. We can see there is an event called View Search Results. Let's select this event. And we can see the search term we entered, which was contact, has been identified as the search term. Let's close this and head back to the demo site again. Now let's play an embedded YouTube video. And let's head back to Tag Assistant. We can see an event for Video Start. Let's select this. This shows us a range of parameters that are captured when people click to play YouTube videos embedded on our website. We can see the URL of the embedded video and the title of the video. We can also see the current time, which is 0 since we just clicked to start playing the video, and the total duration of the video, and the percentage of the video we've played. Let's close this. Since the video is still playing on my demo website, we can see there are additional video progress events that have been collected. These events are sent to Google Analytics when people watch 10, 25, 50, and 75% of the video. Let's select one of these. We can see the same parameters we saw earlier, including the URL of the video and video title. But for this event, we can also see the percentage and current time. Let's close this. Now that the video has finished playing, we can see there is a video complete event. Let's select this. It's similar to the other two events we've just looked at, but this time the current time is the same as the full duration of the video and the video percent is 100. Okay, let's close this and head back to the demo site. Finally, let's download a file. And let's head back to Tag Assistant one last time. We can see there is a file download event. Let's select this. We can see details for the file we clicked to download, including the full URL of the file path and name, and the file type. And we can also see the ID used for the link and the text used to link to the file. Now that we've covered all of the events that can be sent to Google Analytics 4 using the enhanced measurement feature, I want to touch on reporting. So let's head to Google Analytics. And let's select the events report. This is where you can see all of the events that have been collected into your Google Analytics 4 property. For my demo site, we know that there are events automatically sent by enhanced measurement. These are the click event for outbound links, the file download event for people downloading files, the page view event when people view the pages on our website, the scroll event for scroll tracking, the video start, video progress, and video complete events for people watching embedded YouTube videos, and the view search results event for people searching within our website. Let's select the click event to view the default report. We can see the report only includes top-level metrics for the click event. This is because the parameters we saw in Tag Assistant are not automatically included in your reports. To see details for events, including events automatically sent by enhanced measurement, you will need to register them to use them in your reports. To do this, you'll need to navigate to Custom Definitions, and then select either Custom Dimensions or Custom Metrics. Dimensions are typically for reporting on text-based parameters, while metrics are for numerical parameters. Let's say we want to report on the specific outbound links people are clicking. In this case, we need to create a custom dimension. We name the dimension. In this example, I'm going to call it Link URL. I'm going to leave Event as the scope, and we can enter a short description. And then we need to select the event parameter. This needs to be the exact parameter that is being sent to Google Analytics, so I'm going to select Link URL. We can now save our custom dimension. Now let's head back to the events report. And let's select the click event again. If we scroll down, we can now see the parameter we registered as a custom dimension. Now, moving forward, we'll begin to see the different outbound links people are clicking on in the report. You'll need to register any other parameters you also want to use in your reports. To learn more about parameters and Google Analytics 4, check out my GA4 course. You can find a link in the description below this video. So that's how you can use enhanced measurement to track important actions taking place on your website. When you first create your Google Analytics 4 property, enhanced measurement will be enabled by default. This means it's likely you'll already be tracking these actions into your reports. I recommend taking the time to review your reports, and if there are any events you don't want to track automatically, then you can disable them for each of your data streams. Are you using enhanced measurement in GA4? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below. And if you found this video helpful, please subscribe, share it with your friends, and hit the like button so I know to make more videos like this. See you next time.